Now things are gonna get really exciting now because we're getting into some of the really juicy techniques. In fact, this one's all about inking and watercoloring and glimmering over all those fun mediums. We call it foiling over mediums, and I'm bringing in our resident expert at the Glimmer Hot Foil System, and that is Josie. She's gonna be right in here to share all the good tips and tricks with you.
Hey everybody, Josie here with Spellbinders, and today I'm going to show you guys how to easily foil over different types of mediums. It's not a hard thing to do, but there is a trick that we're going to show you. The best thing to do is put your mediums down first and then foil on top of them. And the reason that we do that is because, I'll show you a couple samples here. If you do foil first, you see the shine of the foil. If you tend to do your mediums after your foil, you will dull the shine. I'm not saying that you can't do it that way, but the best way to do it and the best way that we found to do it is to definitely put your inks down, your watercolors down, or whatever you want to foil on top of down on your surface and then foil. So I'm just gonna go ahead and jump right in and get started. So I went ahead and stenciled the moon, and this is what I'm gonna do today. It's this moon here. But I went ahead and I stenciled it in purple just to show you guys that it doesn't always have to be blue. And also you can foil over any color that you'd like. And these are distress inks that I'm using. You could either use distress oxides or you could use the regular distress inks. They foil beautifully. One thing that you want to keep in mind when you're doing this is make sure that your ink is heat set or you've stenciled prior and just let it dry thoroughly before you get started with the stenciling. And I don't know about you guys, I know that sometimes when I'm working on stuff and you get to the very last step and then you do that last thing and it ruins everything and you have to start over. So instead of just starting directly on your stenciled piece, if you're a little bit hesitant or you're still learning how to glimmer and you just want to make sure that your machine is working great and it's heated up to the right temperature, just go ahead and practice on a piece of scrap paper. So that way you know that you're getting a full coverage with your foil. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'm just gonna go ahead and foil on a piece of scrap paper. And this is one of those things that everybody is gonna learn. This is something that everybody's gonna practice and you are gonna find your own way of doing things. We're trying just to do a condensed version for everybody just to show you the best things that we've learned and the best tips that we have. But again, the more that you use the machine, the more confident you'll get and you will learn different ways how to do it. I like to tape things down, whereas other people don't. So I'm going to go ahead and work backwards. So you're going to start with your paper on the bottom. And this is a Nina 80 pound smooth. And then I'm going to start with my foil and I start with the shiny side up. And then I'm going to take my plate and I'm going to place it facing down. And like I said, I like to tape my things in place. Again, you don't have to. And this tape is great for that because it does not get all gummy with the heat. And it removes easily from the paper and from the plate. So there I have it all set up. So again, it's the Nina White, the smooth, the foil. And this is polished brass. This is my favorite gold. It's my go-to gold. It has a deeper color. That's why it's called the brass. It has more of a brassy finish, I guess you could say. We called it polished brass. But it has a deeper shine to it than our regular gold foil. So now I'm going to go ahead and place this on the machine, and I'm going to place it with the flat part of the plate down on the heated surface. And then I'm going to go ahead and put my plates on top. I'm going to push my button here. And as you can see, my machine's already heated up. So you'll know that your machine is ready to go when this green button is solid. Once that's solid, you're going to push your timer button and that will start flashing. And once that's finished flashing, that will indicate that everything is heated up to the right temperature and it's ready to run through your platinum machine, whether you have a platinum 6 or platinum 8. While we're waiting, I'm just going to go ahead and show you a couple other cards. So this one here is done on watercolor paper, and this is watercolor medium here that was just splashed on it beforehand. Here is another card, And again, this is watercolor paper, and this just has a splash of watercolor, and then it was foiled on top. And then this one here is distress inks. And then we just went ahead and foiled the Zodiac on top of that. All right, so now that my machine is ready, you'll see that this indicator light here, the timer light, has gone to a solid green. So I'm gonna go ahead and gently pull the base off the machine and then move it over to the die cutting machine. And I'm gonna slowly just run it through. And as I'm running it through, I like to just go ahead and hold the plates in place. And then I run it back towards myself. You don't have to do that. When things are taped in place, you don't tend to get any sort of movement on your plates. So that's another reason I like to tape things in place. So then I'm gonna go ahead, and I always put the base back in the cradle for two reasons. One, if I want to keep foiling, you don't want this to cool down, and it's just a good place to put it because it is hot and you just want to be careful not to burn yourself. And so that way, if it's always in the cradle and the base, then you know where it's at. And then I'm going to go ahead and lift this up, and I'm just going to peel this tape here, and voila, there you go. And it's that simple. And I got a great solid foil on there. So now I'm going to go ahead and do it on my stenciled moon. Again, now your plates are going to be hot, so you're going to want to be careful when you're touching them. I mean, they cool off pretty quickly, so they're easy to handle. And I went ahead and trimmed my foil down. And I know that Cam is going to be talking about a hinge technique, and we're going to be doing that here because I want to make sure that when I glimmer my sentiment, I want to glimmer it right in the center of the moon. And rather than die cutting my moon out first, I'm going to go ahead and leave it on the piece of paper, foil, and then cut it out after I'm finished. So I'm going to go ahead and take a piece of tape that's a little bit wider, and I am just going to tape it in place. And this is what we call a hinge method. And like I said, Kim will be back to show you guys how to do this with different plates. And then I'm going to go ahead and take my foil, again, shiny side up. I'm going to put it right there under the tape. And then I'm going to flip my plate down. So what this does with the tape, now I know that it's not going to move. It's in place and I have my foil underneath. If you have a little bit of excess foil sticking out, all you have to do is just lift it up and you can trim that away. And then I'm going to take another piece of tape. I'm going to go ahead and tape it just down here. The nice thing about this tape, it doesn't pull up the medium either off the paper. So now I'm going to go ahead and set this down flat side on the heating surface. I'm going to put my plates on, push my button, and once the indicator goes solid, I will go ahead and run it through the machine. So my light, as you guys can see, the timer light here is solid. So I'm going to go ahead and take this out of the base. Again, I'm going to put it on the platform here, hold the plates in place and get going on that. And you see, you go much slower than when you're die cutting. And again, not everybody runs it back, but I'm going to go ahead and run it back towards myself. I'm going to place it back in the base and push it in. So that way you know that it's going to keep heating up while you're working. I'm going to remove the plates. And then here's the big reveal. So turn this over. That. And voila. There you go. There's the perfect glimmered moon. And so this stencil, just so everybody knows, it does work with our essential circles. So I'm going to go ahead and just die cut it out for you so you guys get the full effect. And the great thing about the tape is you can use this tape over and over again. It holds its adhesive really well. So I'm going to go ahead and just tape this in place. And if you guys notice that we purposely did this, that The moon stencil bleeds off the edge, so when you die cut it, you get a very crisp edge. So now I'm gonna go ahead and die cut the moon out of the paper, just so you guys get the full effect of what it looks like. So now I've got my foil machine, it's in the base, it's still heating up. It's right here, the green light's on, that means it's still heating up. So if you guys are working, and let's say you get caught up doing something else or finishing your project, if this light goes off, you just switch your machine off, switch it back on, and it heats up right away. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this in here with my cutting plate. There's my moon that's been foiled and stenciled. And now I'm just gonna go ahead, cut this out. And here we go. We have a beautifully foiled moon with a great sentiment. And let me go ahead and show you the set that the sentiment comes from. So you have, we all sparkle under the same sky, never stop looking up, and in a sky full of stars, you shine the brightest. And all three of this work great with the moon stencil. Well, thanks for joining me today. I really appreciate your time. And if you guys have any other questions or need to know anything else, please check out all our Glimmer hot foil tutorials. We'll have tips and tricks there. And again, you can always reach out with any questions that you have. Thanks again for your time.